As you add contacts to the application, it becomes more difficult for the user to find a specific contact. In this lesson, we will change the order in which results are returned and implement a filter that allows user to search for a particular contact. So we will do this in the contacts page. And the first thing that we will do is actually to change the order in which contacts are returned from the database. And so this means that we need to change something here in the aggregate that fetches the contacts from the database. And let me open up here the aggregate. And as you can see, we have here the results from the database. And what I would like to do is to sort by the contact name. So let me select here. Let's sort these from A to Z. And now we will have our contacts in this order in our screen. Okay, so this will make life easier for the end user to find the contact, but what makes it even easier is to have the possibility to search for a specific contact. And to do this, we'll need to add an input here in the UI for the user to type in the contact name. So let's just do that. Let me drag and drop an input here right above the table records. And let me just complement this with a button because we will need to send this information that the user types back to the server. And let me label the button search. And now let's fix these errors. We have an error here on the input because we need to set a variable to hold the selected value. So to hold the value that the user types here in this input. We will right-click here on the screen and add a local variable. This variable will hold the value entered by the user, and it has a local scope. This means that we can use it here in the UI, we can use it in the preparation, and we can also use it in all the screen actions that the screen has. Okay? Let me just rename the variable to search keyword. We're done. Let me bind this variable to the input by filling in the variable property and select here search keyword. Now we still need to fix this error here in the button. And again, I'm going to double click to create the action, the search action, and bind it to this button. And well, now we need to think a little bit what we're going to do here in this search action. And actually to go over this, let me just go back here to the screen and let's review the life cycle of this page when we press this search button. So when the user presses the search button, this will trigger a request back to the server that will execute the search action. And what we've seen in the previous lessons was that these screen actions would redirect the user to another page. But in this case, I want to keep the user in the same page. I want to keep him in the contacts page, but filter the results that we have on the screen. And this means that I need to execute the preparation of the screen. And actually, this is what happens when the screen action ends with the end node that we have there by default. So when it reaches this end node, next the preparation will be executed. We have the aggregate in the preparation that fetches the contacts from the database. And let me just switch colors here. It's on this aggregate that we want to use the search keyword. And with this search keyword, we want to fetch that contact from the database, and then we will have the server-side rendering stage where we are going to render the table records one element at a time. And once this is done, we are going to send the response back to the user's browser to be rendered on the screen. Now, since we're going to use this information, the search keyword, this is going to be used in the preparation, we don't actually need to do anything here in this screen action. We don't have to change anything in this value because once this is sent to the server, the typed value, let's say that the user types in here Joanna, and this value is sent to the server, it will be held here in this variable, and we don't need to change anything here because the variable will hold this value when it reaches the preparation as well. Okay, so let's go back to Service Studio and implement the filtering in the aggregate using this variable. So we'll need to go into the preparation and open the aggregate, and let's add a filter to our aggregate. And what we want to check is the contact name. We want it to match the search keyword. Okay, so this will return only one record. In this case, this is Alfred. You can use here the test values to, for instance, let's search for Joanna that we've been using in our examples. And this, well, this doesn't return Joanna. And actually, I figured it out why it doesn't return Joanna, because in my filter here, I am comparing the contact name to be equal to the search keyword. Now, Joanna's name is not only Joanna, it's Joanna Rivera, so we don't have any results. But we want to change this so that the user doesn't have to type the whole name. So let's open here the condition, and we will need to change here this operator, the equal, to use something different. And we're going to use the like operator. And this operator here, the like operator, allows you to use wildcards to search for a pattern within this attribute. Now, the wildcard that we're going to use here is a percentage, and this is just a special character that can be used in combination with the like operator on filter conditions in our aggregate. It represents any character that comes, in this case, before my search keyword, and I can also use it in the end to add any character that appears after my keyword. So basically what we're doing here is we're finding the pattern on the contact name, we're finding the pattern Joanna with any character before and after that pattern. So this gives me the result that I want. We're done. Let's just publish, and we will use the debugger. So let me just add a breakpoint here. We will use the debugger to review the life cycle of the application. Okay, before we search, let me just make sure that we have the debugger running. Let me go back here and start the debugger. We will stop the execution in the search action. So let me go back here and let's search for Joanna. And here we have, we're stopped in the breakpoint. Remember that we have a local variable that will hold the value type by the user. So here in the locals, there we have it, search keyword and the value that we typed. So let's step over again and step into, and there we have it. We are executing the preparation of the contact screen, and the variable still holds the value that the user typed in. So this is going to be used, let's just step over and step over again. This is going to be used in the aggregate. And now, if we look here into the list, there we have it. We are returning the contact Joanna Rivera. And if we continue, we will see this in our application. That's it.